What gets compiled? And there is no syntactical errors. And if you user want to print 2 plus 2, then output also correct. Like if you enter 2 plus 2, then you get the 4, not 5, anything. Everything is works perfect. There is no compiled errors. There is no logical errors. Coming to, here, let me give an example for the runtime error so you can understand it better. Okay. Yeah. Let me give A equals to 10, B equals to 0. Here I just want to divide A by B. Okay, let me print A by B. See, I got the output that is the division, zero division error, that is division by zero. Here everything works perfectly because means there is no syntactical errors and there is no logical errors also. But here we are getting error. These type of errors we can call it as the runtime error because here mistake is not done by the user. Here mistake is done by the you. I mean his mistake is not done by the developer. Here mistake is done by the user. Like instead of default values, let me give. Okay, enter number 2. Okay. See, here user is giving some output. That is, first of all, here I am the user right now. Here I'm entering first number as a 6. And here I'm entering the second number as 0. See, we got the output that is a 0 by division by 0. As a developer, I knows if at all if we print the number by 0, then we can got the d division by division by 0 errors. But as a developer, in my mind, I am thinking that user is not supposed to give 0 as the second number, but user exactly doing that. So okay, and all this and I mean all these comes under the runtime errors. As a, I may think that it's a user problem. I don't want to do anything. As a developer, you are not supposed to think like that. As a developer, you have to take care all the things. Okay. Even so you have to take care of this type of errors. Okay, like if you are getting an exception, getting I mean getting exceptions, getting errors, the executions should not stop. That's the main logic here. Okay. Okay. And if you take some real-time examples, that is banking or anything, in bankings there may contain some errors, but execution is not supposed to should not stop because if execution stop, then there be a loss of $1 million of money anything. So okay, this is all about the exception handling. Okay, we can overcome these type of errors by using the try except concept. Okay, let me give an example. Let me explain what is this try concept and what is this except concept. This Python for this type of errors, this Python provides a way to handle the exception so the code can be executed without any interruption. If we do not handle the exception, the interpreter doesn't execute all the code and that exists after the execution. Okay, like Python has many built-in exceptions that enable our program to run without interruption and give the output. Those inbuilt exceptions are zero division error, name error. Zero division errors means when it occurs when a number is divided by zero, like in this way. And there is another inbuilt error, that is a name error. It occurs when a name is not found. It may be like it's like a global or a local or global. And there are some inbuilt like indentation error, like if correct, if incorrect indentation is given. And there is an IO error, like it occurs when an input and output operation fails. These are all some of the inbuilt exceptions, okay? Okay. Now coming to the main concept, that is exception handling in Python. Like if the Python program contains suspicious code that may throw an error, we must place that code in the try block. Here what the try block must be followed with an except statement, which contains the block of code that will be executed if there is some exception in the try block. If there is no exception, then the statements which are in the try block will be executed. If there is an exception, then the except statement will be executed. Let me give an example so that you can understand it better. See, here I just want to put all the statements in the try block. If there is no error, then all the statements will be executed. Okay, here try block says that, okay, I will execute all the statements. Okay, fine. But what if an error contains? And as a developer, now I'm saying that, hey, you don't worry about this. If an except, okay, I will execute, I mean, if an exception occurs, here I'm the programmer, I will provide one exception statement. Hey, you don't worry about that. Let me provide an except statement for this. Sorry. Here I'm providing an except statement. Here I am giving that value, that is on divide by zero. Okay. Enter a number, that is 1. Let me enter. See, I got the output, that is con divided by 0. Right before we got the output, that is division by 0. Now here I got the output, that is in con divided by 0. This is how try and except block works, okay? As we we are the programmer, we have to provide some statements in the except block. Okay, if any error occurs, then the statements which are in the except block will be executed. This is all about the try concept and except concept. And here there is another concept, that is an else statement. Like we can use this else statements with the try except statement, in which we can place the code which will be executed in the scenario if no exception occurs in the try block. Let me explain about everything clearly. Here try block, here it runs the code generally. Coming to the except block, here if there is any error occurs in the try block, then this except block will be executed. And there is another block, that is here I'm mentioning, that is else block. If any error not occurred in this try block, then the statements are in the else block will be executed. Now here I just want to print that anything. Okay, now let me print my output. See here, first of all, let me enter a number, that is 1. Now let me enter. See, I got the output, that is here, except block will be executed because there is an error in the try block. It is in a zero time error. Okay, now let me here let me enter in it. See, here I got the statements. I mean, here I got the output that is X something. I mean, this state, I mean, here the statements which are in the else block will be executed because there is no error in the try block. I have already said that if there is an error occurs in the try block, then the exception statements will be printed. If there is no error occurred in the try block, then the else statements will be executed. This is the difference between the except statement and the else statement. Okay, I hope everything is clear till now. This is all about the try block, except block, and else block. Okay, now let me explain some other thing that is an except statement with no except. I mean, with an exception. Okay, we can provide here exception also. Okay. There is no changes in the output. See, we got the same output. If we mention here exception or else, if we not mention here exception, the output will not change. Means Python here provides the flexibility not to specify the name of the exception in with the exception statement and provide the exception statement with the except statement. Okay. This is all about the exception, try block, else, and except with the exception statement. Now, let me give here. I just here I got the output. If at all I gave the zero as the second number, I got the output that is can't divide by zero. But here I just want to know the exact error. So we can also know the correct exact error by using an variable, exception variable. Means here we can use the exception variable with the except statement. It is used by using the as keyword. Okay, this object generally will return the cause of the exception. Okay, here I just want to here I'm using the as keyword as e. Okay, now let me print the cause of the exception. First of all, let me enter a number that is 1 and the second number is 0. See, here I got the output. First of all, that is can't divide by 0. Okay, everything is okay. This is clear. And after that, I got the cause of an error, that is division by 0. Okay, means here if at all if you use the exception variable, then we can go then we may know that the what is that cause of the exception. Okay, if at all if you want to know, this is all about the except handling. There are some points that we should remember. Like generally, this Python facilitates us to not specify the except with the exception with the except statement, and we can declare multiple exception in the except block since the try block may contain the statements which throw the different types of exceptions. Okay, not only single statement, we can use here multiple exceptions also. We just try once. Okay. We may we can also specify the else block along with the try except statement. I have explained how to do this, which will be executed if no exception is raised in the try block. Okay, I mean the statements and the last point is the statements that don't throw the exceptions should be placed inside the else block. These are all the points you should remember. Okay, I hope everything is clear till now. Let me delete all this. Okay, here the final concept is final block. This what is this final block? Generally, this Python provides the optional finally statement, which is used with the try statement. Okay, it is executed no matter whether an exception occurs, and whether an exception occurs or whether an exception not occurs. No matters, the final block, the final statement will be executed. Okay, we can use this finally block with the try block, in which we can paste the necessary code which must be executed before the try block, try statement. If a try statement throws an error, then we can place those statements in the finally block. Let me give an example. Here, let me mention that is in a try. That is here. I just want to give. Let me open a file. That is, what is this? One second. Okay. File.txt. Sorry. Txt. I just want to open it in a read mode. Okay. And now here I want to give final. File dot. Now I just want to write some code, lines of code. Hey, that's it. Now here I just want to mention this finally block. Like here I want to close. First of all, let me close my file. Now here I want to write something that now let me mention my except. Sorry, okay. Let me run my code now. See, I got the output that is an error because why am I getting error? Because this generally file, fi.txt is not there. I mean, it is not, okay. Let me give an a, what is this? Okay. Now see about the output, that is one is the, and the another thing is here error. If at all there is an exception in the try block, but here the statements which are involved in the finally statement is executed. Okay, generally this final is what is this finally block means. It no matters whether an exception is occurs, whether an exception not occurs, the statements will executed anyway. Okay. Let me explain what about each and every term. That is, first of all, try block. This try block, the statements which are present in the try block, this will be compiled. And coming to the except, it runs the statements which are in the except statement will run if an exception occurs. Okay, if there is no exception, then the statements which are in the else block will be executed. And coming to the finally block, it always runs the code whether an exception occurs, whether an exception not occurs. This is all about the exception handling. And coming to the next important topic, that is the rising exceptions. Okay, like we can rise exception forcefully. Like an exception can be raised forcefully by using the rise clause in Python. Okay, it is useful in that scenario where we need to raise an exception to stop the execution of the program. Coming to the real-time example, okay, there is a program that requires 2 GB memory for execution, okay? And if the program tries to occupy 2 GB of memory, then we have to raise an exception to stop the execution of the program. And in that time, these rising exceptions are used. We can forcefully raise an exception using this rise statement, okay? And there are some points that we should remember to raise an exception. That is, to raise an exception, the rise statement is used, the exception class name follows it. And An exception can be provided with the value that cannot be given in the parenthesis, okay? And if at all, I have already explained that if at all, if you want to access the value, here we are using the as keyword, is used, and e is used to, as, and here e is used as a reference variable which stores the value of the execution. And we can pass the value of the value of an exception to specify the exception type. Let me give an example for the rising exception. Okay. First of all, let me mention my try block. Okay. Here, let me give a factor that is S. Enter your yes. And now here I'm saying that if your yes is less than 18. Okay. Now here I just want to raise an error. That is, okay. Raise that value error. Okay. Or else. Here I just want to print. Want to print that S is valid if the S not greater, if the S is greater than 18. Okay. Now here I successfully raised the exception. I have already said that to raise an exception, the raise statement is used, I mean, and the exception class name follows it. Okay. Now let me, okay. What type of error? Here I'm mentioning value error. In this statement here, I just want to give that the age is, sorry, not valid. Let me print it. Here I'm entering my age, that is 12. See, I got the output that is. Let me enter my age, that is 11. Here I got the output that is an age is not valid. Here I raised an exception, that is here I raised an exception that is in a value error, because here value is wrong, right? So here I got the output that is in a age is not valid. Let me print it again. Let me give an output that is 23. If at all I enter here 23, there is no error in this try block. So if there is no error, then what it means? If there is no error in the try block, then the statements which are in the else block will be executed, right? So here no error means 23 is greater than 18. So here the statements which are in the else block will be executed. Okay. See, I got the output that is the age is valid, because else block is else statement is executed here. This is all about the rising an error. Okay. This is how we can raise an error. You just do practice so that only you can then only you can understand what is this errors, what is this rising errors and everything. Okay, this is all about the exception handling, guys. Let me close my PyCharm. Now there is a one concept, like there is a one concept that is a whoop concept. I explained this whoop concept after explaining Python CS, I mean, what is this, HTML CSS. Okay, actually, first of all, I have to start the Python, I mean, front end languages, then only I have to start the back end languages, because I mean, only a few days ago, people, I mean, you guys said that we are not even familiar with the front end languages. Okay, so I have to start the front end languages right now. Now I am going to teach you guys about the HTML. Within 4 days, I will complete the HTML part. Then I will start the CSS part. After CSS part, I will give a little bit introduction about the JavaScript, and after that, I will start the Django part. I mean, sorry, Django part, that basically backend. These HTML, CSS, let me close my, okay. These HTML, CSS, and JavaScript are for front end. If you learn properly these HTML, CSS, JavaScript, then you can apply for the front end developer roles. Okay. If you learn Django, then you can apply for both front end and back end. Then you can apply for full stack web developer roles. Okay. Like if you are familiar, if you are expert in Python, then you can go with that. What is this data science? Like if you are interested in that particular area, then also you can go with that area. Or else HTML CSS is generally easy. JavaScript is a little bit tough. Okay. Actually, one second. I will send one pic in WhatsApp. One second. Yes, please check your WhatsApp. I have sent one picture. Okay. I have exams from 23 to 25, like 23, 24, 25. Generally I have exams from 29 to 30, but the exams are preponed. So I can't take classes from 23 to 25, 23, 24, 25. So there is a lot of syllabus. So I just want to take in extra classes. Is it okay for everyone?
Okay, madam.
Ma'am, like when will you take the extra classes?
Extra classes, yeah, okay. 16 Monday, right? Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Monday, 16 to 90, I just want to take double classes, like 5 to 6, right? I just want to take 5 to 7. And I'm not available from 20 to 25. Actually, I have some work related, mini project work. I have to make documents and everything. 16, 17, 18, 19 double classes. Like generally you have 1 hour, right? I just want to take 5 to 6, 5 to 7. Is it okay for everyone? Guys, please give response. 5 to 7, 2 hours. Ma'am, can you take from 15 to 18? 15 Sunday, right? Yeah, it's 15 to 18. Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. 15 to 18. Is it okay for everyone? Yes, ma'am, 15 to, okay. Guys, please give response, everyone.
Yeah, ma'am, it's fine, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Okay, thank you. Now I'm going to teach you guys. Now I just want to start the HTML part. Trust me, HTML is very, very, very easy. Yeah, okay. Let me start. Let me give somewhat, I mean, some introduction about this HTML. Okay. One second. Okay. Generally, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. First of all, HTML is not a programming language. It's a markup language, okay? This HTML is used to create web pages and web applications, okay? And this HTML widely used language on the web. We can create static websites by HTML only. If at all, if you want to create a static website, then you can create it by using HTML only. Like I have said that HTML is not a programming language. It's a markup language, okay? Now, what should I start? Here, I am using Notepad++. Notepad++. Even you can use Notepad also. Like there are different text editors, that is Notepad, Notepad++, Brackets, Sublime, it's my favorite one. But as a fresher, as a beginner, I'm recommend you guys to use Notepad or Notepad++. Okay. In this HTML part, I'm gonna teach you guys examples for each topic with some explanation, and you can also edit and run those examples. And the one thing is, learning HTML is a fun and it's very, very easy to learn. Okay, don't worry about that. If at all, if you spend 5 hours on HTML, then one second. Okay. Here, okay. Now I just want to give somewhat introduction about these text editors. Like an HTML file is a text file. So to create an HTML file, we can use any text editors, that is Notepad, Notepad++, Sublime, and what is it, Brackets. And these text editors are the programs which allow editing in a written text. Hence, to create a web page, we need to write our code in some text editors. And there are various types of text editors available which you can directly download. But I have said that, but for a beginner or a fresher, the best text editor is a Notepad for Windows. Or text edit for Mac, okay? After learning basics, you can easily use these professional text editors, that is Sublime Text, etc. Here in this course, I'm gonna teach you, I'm going to use this Notepad++, okay? Rather than that, Notepad is a simple text editor and suitable for the beginners to learn HTML. It is available in all versions of the HTML from where you easily access it, okay? This is all about text editors. It's all about your wish. But as a beginner, I am recommending you guys to use the Notepad, okay? Yeah, now coming to the HTML. HTML, I have said that HTML stands for the Hypertext Markup Language, which is used for creating web pages and web applications. Okay. And what is this hypertext? It's like a hypertext markup language, right? And coming to that, what is this hypertext means? Hypertext simply means text within text. A text has a link, once again. What is this hypertext means here? It is generally text within the text means here it has some links within it, and I mean it is in a hypertext. Whenever you click on a link, which brings you to a new page, like if you I mean you have already experienced that if you click on one link, then it will turns to the another page like that. It is a hypertext, okay? New web page, you have clicked on a hypertext, and hypertext is a way to link two or more web pages. Okay, like if you type Python then in Google, then it will then it will redirects to another web page, then after that it will redirects to another web page. Here this hypertext is links two or more web pages. This is all about the hypertext. And coming to the markup language, a markup language is a computer language that is used to apply layout and formatting conventions to a text document. Markup language makes this markup language makes text more interactive and dynamic. It can turn text into like images, tables, links, everything. Okay. And there is another keyword that is in a web page. Generally, what is in a web page? A web page is a document which is commonly written in HTML and it translated by a web browser. Okay. And a web page can be identified by entering a URL, okay? And a web page can be often a static or a dynamic tag. With the help, I have said already earlier, I have said that with the help of the HTML only, we can create the static web pages. And HTML, I mean, since this HTML is a markup language, which is used for creating attractive web pages with the help of styling and which looks in a nice format on a web browser. And HTML document is made up of many HTML tags, and each HTML tag contains different content. I have created many web pages, like I did these all HTML pages like 2 years ago, I think so. Almost I forgotten everything. Okay. Let me explain, I mean, let me create one simple example for the HTML. So here I just want to mention. One second. Doctor, I will explain these terms. You don't worry. HTML and followed by head. And it followed by here. I just want to give title. What is this? First program. Now here I just want to close this title tag. Okay. And here I just want to close this head tag. Okay. In body. No, paragraph. P here, P stands for paragraph. Oh, you don't worry, I will explain each and everything. First program, what is this? Python. Let me close this paragraph. Okay, enough. Now let me close my body tag. Sorry. Now here I just want to close my HTML tag. Okay. Everything clear, right? Okay. Now let me run this program. First of all, let me save. Okay. Where is this run here? Launching Chrome. One second. See. Okay. See here, I got value that is Python. I mean Python, because Python is present in the body, and here the title is first program. Okay. I hope you. I mean, first of all, let me explain these tags. Okay, so that only you can understand how that Python is executed there. Here, generally, what is this doc type means? It defines the document type, or it instructs the browser about the version of the HTML. And it followed by what is this HTML, okay? This tag informs the browser that it is in a HTML document, okay? And thus text between this HTML, tag describes the web document. It is in a container of all other documents of the HTML except the document. See here, first of all, here I mentioned the HTML tag, and finally here I mentioned this closing HTML tag. Generally, tag means it has some opening, greater than, less than symbol. Okay. It is in a container, like for all, all the elements are presented in between this HTML opening and closing tag. Okay. And it followed by what is this head tag. This head tag, it should be the first element inside the HTML. After the HTML tag, and after that, you should mention this head tag only. Okay. And which contains the metadata, like information about this document. Here, so that only here I mentioned this title tag. Let me explain what is this for the first term. It must be closed before the body tag. Here, see. Here I closed the head tag before the body tag starts. This is the rule of the head tag. Your head tag must be closed before the body tag starts. In this head tag, elements which contains the metadata, like information about this document, is presented in this head tag. And it followed by what it is, title tag. As the name, we can see that it is as the name suggested, that we can it is used to add the title of that HTML page, which appears at the see generally this title tag, which appears at the top of the browser window. Top of the browser window, it must be placed inside the head tag and should be closed immediately. Generally, it's an optional. Okay. This is all about the title tag, and followed by what we have, body tag. The text between the body tag describes the body content of the web page. In this web page, if at all, if you want to write anything, any information, then all this content, all these elements are should be in between the body tag only. Okay. This describes the body. The body content of the page that is visible to the end user. The content which is written in the body tag, which we can see in the web browser. Simply, we can say that this tag contains the main content of the HTML document. Okay. Followed by there is another tag that is in a P tag. This P tag, the text between P tag describes the paragraph of the web page. There are other tags also, that is a H1 tag generally, which is used for heading of the web page. Everything I will explain about this heading tag. This is a simple web page. I hope everything is clear, like what is this HTML, what is this head, what is this title, and what is this body, when to represent, where to represent this HTML, head, title, and everything. Okay. Now, let me give somewhat brief introduction about this HTML, like how this HTML evolves from, since 1980s to 2020s. Okay. In the late 1980s, okay, Tim Berners-Lee, who was a contractor at a CERN, proposed the system of the CERN researchers. Okay, and in 1989, he wrote a memo proposing an internet-based hypertext system. Okay, and this Berners-Lee is known as the father of the HTML. Okay, And the first available description of HTML was, I mean, was a document called HTML tags proposed by these Berners. I mean, we can call him as a Tim also, in late 99. And the latest version of the HTML is HTML5. Okay. First of all, let me explain all the versions. Let me explain the latest version soon. Okay. Let me explain about this HTML version. Since the time HTML was invented, there are lots of HTML versions in the market. Like the first version is HTML 1.0. Like this first version of the HTML was 1.0, which was a bare bones version of the HTML language. And it was released in 1991. And the second version is HTML 2.0. This was the next version, which was released in the 1995, and it was standard language version for website design. Okay, and this 2.0 was able to support extra features, not like HTML 1.0, such as form based, file upload, form elements such as a text box, option buttons, everything. And there is another version that is in HTML 3.2, that is which was published in the 1997. This version was capable of creating tables and providing support for extra options to form elements, and it can also support a web page with a complex mathematical equations. And it became an official standard for any browser till January 1997. Okay. Today it is practically supported by most of the browsers, and followed by there is another version that is in HTML 4.01. This version was released on 1997, and it is also very stable version of the HTML language. And this version of the current official standard, and it provides added support for the style sheet, that is the CSS. I will explain it after some days. And the scripting ability for various multimedia elements. Okay, this is all about the HTML 4.01. And finally, the latest version is the HTML 5. This is the newest version of the hypertext markup language. Like the first draft of this version was announced in 2018. And in the latest version, there are two major organizations. Okay, one is World Wide Web Consortium, and the another one is Web Hypertext Application Technology Working Group, okay, which are involved in the development of the HTML version, and still it is an under development. This is the latest version of the HTML. HTML 5 is the latest version. This is then a brief introduction and some basic introduction about the HTML tags and HTML versions. Now let me explain features of the HTML. Okay, it is coming to the features of the HTML. This HTML is a very easy and simple language. Trust me, it is an. Earlier I have said that it is an easy language. Okay, it can be easily understand and modified. Okay. And it is very easy to make an effective presentation with HTML because it has a lot of formatting tags. Trust me, we have many, many types of formatting tags. I may not cover all these tags, but I will try my level best to cover all these HTML tags. There are many tags which makes our web page, web document effective. Okay. And it is in a markup language, so it provides the a flexible way to design web pages along with the text. Okay, and the next one is, and it facilitates programmer to add a link on the web pages. For adding links, there is a tag that is an anchor tag. So it enhances the interest of the browsing of the user. And it is in a platform independent because it can be displayed on any platforms like Windows, Linux, everything. And it facilitates the programmer to add graphics, videos, images, and sound to the web pages, which makes it some more interactive and interactive. Like doing programs like making webs. Using HTML is a fun and it's very funny. Okay. attractive also. We can there. I mean, there is a CSS. We can add more colors, and here we can add videos, graphics. I mean, images, everything. Okay. And the next thing is, here HTML is a case sensitive language, which means we can use tags either in a lowercase or a uppercase. Okay, this is all about the features of the HTML and text editors, and some what basic introduction about these HTML tags. I hope everything is clear till now. Okay. Now I just want to explain you guys about the building blocks of the HTML. Like on a HTML, there are two building blocks of that is in a tags. Second one is attributes. Generally, this tag means this is in a tag. See, let me delete this HTML. This is the tag. This tag surrounds the content and apply meaning to it. Okay. Yeah, this is in a tag. So it is so said that this is written in between the greater than, I mean these brackets, greater than and less than brackets. And what is this attribute means? An attribute in HTML provides an extra information about the element, and it is applied with the start tag. And HTML attribute contains two fields, that is name and value. I will explain these attribute, then only you can understand what is this attribute tag. One second. Okay. First of all, let me, actually there are two building blocks, right? That is the tags and attributes. Let me explain what is this tags, and after the, followed by I will explain a attribute. I have to give some real-time coding examples, then only you can understand what is this attribute. Okay. First of all, let me give some basic introduction about this tags. These HTML tags are like keywords, which defines that how web browser will format and display the content. And with the help of the tags, a web browser can distinguish between a HTML content and a simple content. Okay. And like if at all here, let me mention this H1 tag. Here, I just... Yeah, okay. Let me run. One second. See, here I got the output, that is the one is a means it distinguish between the kind, I mean this Python is a paragraph. Here coming to the one is a, it is in a heading. Okay, means it can distinguish that is the what is the simple content and normal content, everything. And HTML tags contains generally three main points, that is opening tag. Here opening tag, this H1 here is in a opening tag here, and in between this is in a content, and here we got here there is another thing, that is in a closing tag. Okay. There are some tags that are unclosed tags. I will explain them also. Some tags, I mean almost all tags are closed, but there are some tags that are unclosed tags. And when a web browser reads an HTML document, browser reads it from top to bottom and left to right, both top to bottom, and so that only we are giving that height, width and everything. And HTML tags are used to create HTML tags and render their properties. And each HTML tags have different properties. Like if at all, if you are using this HTML tag, what is this paragraph, which returns the content in the paragraph form. If this heading tag has the property, that is, it returns the content in a heading format. And there is another content, that is, there is another tag that, let me mention, that is B. See here, GY is generally in the ball format. I hope you are familiar with what is this ball, and there are some other font styles that is bold, italic, and everything. Like each, I mean, every HTML tag has its own properties. Okay, and in HTML. And the HTML file must have some essential tags so that the web browser can differentiate between the simple text and the HTML tags. You can use many tags as you want as per your code requirement, okay? You can create many tags, okay? Generally, what are these HTML tags? Generally, HTML tags are enclosed with this greater and less than. I don't know exactly. Okay, greater than or less than brackets. And every tag in the HTML performs different tasks. And if you use in the open tag, then you must to use the closed tag, except some tags. Like there are some tags, there is no enclosed tags, okay? This is all about the closing tag. I mean, tags. These are all the tags. Everything, okay? Now, let me explain what is this unclosed HTML tags. Like some HTML tags are not closed. Okay. Let me, for example, if you take a break tag, generally this break stands for the break line. It breaks the lines of the code. And there is another tag that is an HR tag. This HR tag stands for the horizontal rule. This tag is used to put a line across the web page. Okay. This is all about the unclosed HTML tags. Just you please do practice on this HTML tags that is opening class. Closed, unclosed HTML tags, and some closed HTML tags. Let me delete all this. Okay. And there are some other meta tags also, that is title, link. I will explain it very soon. And there are many tags, like there are some heading tags, like H1, H2, like text tags, that is generally these P, H1, H2, we can call them it as in a text tags. If you want to mention any link, then we can use this anchor, that is A tag, base tag. And if you want to upload any images, then we can use this image, area, map, and everything. And there are some, if you want to create lists, then we can use this in many web pages, you can see that there is an list that is, okay. Okay, in many web pages, we can see that there is a list that is I can't exactly Google about this list. Like in many web pages, we can see this lists. Generally, these lists are created by using some tags, that is UL tag, like an order list. I mean, there is an order list. Actually, we have two types of list, that is order list and unorder list, and everything. And we can create, and there are some tags that is form tags. Like in our colleges, in our websites, if you apply for any competitive exams, then we can get one form that is, please enter your name, please enter your mail ID, and everything. This is all about the form tags. Like in form, I mean, there we can use this form input. And in the form form I mean in that form document I mean in that form web page, then we can get some select options, like please select this or that, everything. And we have some options, everything. And finally, there is a button that is a submit button. Everything is created by using this form tags. Okay, we can create the forms by using your form tags. There are many form tags, that is a form input, label, field set and legend, option, select button, and everything. And followed by, we have some table tags, like table have tabs. I didn't remember exactly. Okay, there are generally in web pages we can create these table tags also. Like these tables we have these tables generally we can create it by using the tr, td, th, t body and everything. And okay, this is all about the tags. There are many tags. I will explain each and everything. I will try my level best to explain all the tags. Okay. This is all about the introduction about this HTML tags. Now let me give somewhat introduction about this heading tag. Okay, let me start. Heading. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, this is not a Python, right? Okay. Generally this HTML HTML heading or HTML tag can be defined as a title or a subtitle which you want to display on the website. When you place the text with this HTML tags like H1 so on to closed H1 tag, it is displayed on the web browser in the bold format, and the size of the text depends on the number of the heading. There are many number that is H1. See here H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 until H6. Okay. See, there are six different HTML headings which are defined by the defined with this H1 to H6 tags. From highest level, the highest level is H1 and the lowest level is H6. This H1 tag generally we can use for the main heading. At the least level, H6 tag we can use for the least important heading. Okay, and everything. And this H1 is the largest heading tag and H6 is the smallest one. So H1 said this H1 is used for the most important headings and H6 is used for the least important. Okay. And generally what this heading tags means, these headings in the HTML helps the search engine to understand and index the structure of the web page so that only this these headings tags are used. Let me create everything using these tags. Let me give me that is second one, that is what is this H2. Now another thing, that is sorry. Now let me give that is H4. What is this? Oh, let me. Sorry. Sorry. Okay. Here I'm not mentioning any HTML, okay, whatever. Let me save this. See, I got an output that is Pushpa. There is a sequence that is coming to the Pushpa element. It is in a bigger size compared to the Anjali. Compared to the rest of these elements. This last element, that is H6, is a smaller than compared to the all these tags. This is the difference between H1, H2 and H3 and H1 and H6 and H6. I mean H5 and H6. I said that if you want to mention any important thing, then you can mention that particular content in the H1 tags. Like if you want to mention any important content, then there we can use this H1 tag, and followed by it is H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. This is all about the heading tags in the Python. Okay. Sorry, in the HTML. And there is another thing, that is the HTML headings can also be used with the nested elements. Okay. वन सेकेंड, नाउ लेट मी क्लोज दिस। या बैक टू माय पाइथन। ओके, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस एचटीएमएल टैग्स, अबाउट h1 h2 h3 एंड आफ्टर दैट नाउ आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू एक्सप्लेन यू गाइज अबाउट दी एट्रीब्यूट्स। एक्चुअली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव टू एक्सप्लेन दिस एट्रीब्यूट, दैन ओनली आई हैव टू एक्सप्लेन दिस टैग्स एग्जाम्पल, बट ओके लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस एट्रीब्यूट। आई मीन देर आर अर्लियर आई हैव सेड दैट देर आर टू बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स, वन इज अ टैग एंड द सेकेंड वन इज एट्रीब्यूट। आई हैव क्लियरली मैन एक्सप्लेन वॉट इज दिस टैग 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 मीन्स, and there are many types which are involved in this tag, and okay, and the second one is a html attribute. Let me delete all this. Okay, these html attributes are the special words which provides any additional information about this elements or attributes are the modifier of the html element. And each element of the tag can have attribute which defines the behavior of the of that particular content or the element. Okay, and this and there is another point that we should remember, that this attribute should always be applied with the starting tag only. I will give one example, then only you can understand about this attribute tag. And this attribute should be applied in its name and the value pair also. Okay, and this attribute names and the values are the case sensitive, and it is recommended by the World Wide Web Consortium, and that is it should be written in the lowercase only. Okay, you should remember one thing: attributes only attributes should written in lowercase only. That is then another point, another thing that you should keep in your mind. When you add multiple attributes in one HTML element, but need to give space between two attributes. This is then another thing. Let me give an example. Talk type, and now let me mention all my HTML followed by head. And here I just want to give some title, that is second, and after that here I just want to close this head tag. I just want to start here body tag. In this body tag, let me mention paragraph. See here I am giving attribute. Here, what is this? Here, I just want to make some height, that is 50 pixels only. Here, you have to mention this height in pixels, and followed. One is enough. Okay. Rather than height, let me give color. Color, what is this? Blue. Blue is okay. Okay. HTML. I just want to mention HTML. Let me close my P tag. I mean paragraph tag. This now this is an attribute. Here it will add the style property in this element. Here I am style property. What is the style here? That is here I am adding color, that is blue, to this particular element, that is HTML. Let me run. Let me close my body tag. Okay, now let me close, sorry, HTML. Oh, sorry. See, I got this HTML in the what is this blue color because here I gave that is here I mentioned one property that is style property and here I am mentioning that the color is blue. Okay.
Yes.
Oh, sorry. You're not supposed to give HTML. What if I give H1 here? The beauty of HTML is we don't get any errors here. We just get some different types of outputs only. That's it. I almost forgot HTML. See here, yeah, okay. Now everything is clear. See this HTML. I mean, I have applied this head. I mean, H1 tag, and on the other hand, I have applied this attribute. I mean, here I have applied this style property that I have mentioned that is color. That I just want to print this HTML in the blue color. And everything works perfectly. This is the all about this HTML. And you can even mention you can even give two attributes also. Let me give height, that is okay. Just put comma over here. And comma height. Here I just want to give 40 pixels. You should save every time. If at all, if you are using this Notepad +++, maybe Notepad also. Sorry. Let me check at least. See, I got the output that is H1. What about this H height tag? Whatever. Let me mention this 100 pixels. What the hell is happening? Okay. I will explain about this HTML, I mean height tag tomorrow. Okay. I just don't want to waste time. One second. Okay. Let me add some more tag here. P style blue followed by which height that is 40 pixels followed by column blue. And here HTML. Yeah, okay. Now it works perfectly. I just got this HTML in the height of 40. I don't know about this, I mean height width, but whatever, I got this HTML in the height of 40. Okay. If you use, if you mention more, and if you give more content, then you can know this height and width property. Okay, if here I'm using only two elements, so here I'm not understanding about this height and width. Actually, there are two types, that is height and width. We can give width also, but here I'm mentioning only two properties, two elements only. So that's why here I'm confusing, like what is this height, what is this weight of this particular web page. Okay. This is all about these. You can use two attributes, and even you can use the one attribute. This is all about the attribute tag. Okay. This is generally this is in a style attribute. Okay. This attribute is generally used for applying the CSS property. Here, this style, this height, I mean this, sorry, this color, this height, these are all coming under the CSS properties. If you are familiar with the CSS properties, then we have many properties, that is height, color, font, what is this, width, and everything. Okay, CSS means adding. I mean, it's like markup. Yeah, generally we can say that it's a markup. Like we can add, we can designs, we can color them, we can make more beautiful, we can make web pages more attractive. That's it. That is the CSS properties. Okay. And here I'm providing the height, that is in a 40 pixel. And here I'm giving the color blue, so it turns that so I got this HTML statement with the color blue and height height 40 pixel. This is all about these attributes. Okay. I hope everything is clear till now. And there are some other attributes also, that is an href attribute. This href attribute is the main attribute of an anchor tag. Generally, it is used for links. This attribute gives the link address which is specified in that. Okay, this href attribute provides the hyperlink, and if it is black, then it will remain the same same page. What is this anchor tag means? It is used for links. And coming to this HR attribute, it provides the hyperlink. Let me explain. Here I am opening my anchor tag. Here, let me give this href attribute. Here, I just want to what the web page. Okay, let me give here. Sorry. Okay. And now let me close this. So here I just want to give one thing that Google did. Let me mention, let me close my anchor tag. Okay. Let me save this. Just print the output. See, here I'm clicking Google, then it runs to the Google page. This is how web browser links. Like if you mention anything, like if at all if you type here, then we got that is HTML. And if you click here, click here, then it will turns to some of these all links, redirecting links, and everything is happened by using this href attribute. Okay, let me close this. This is all about this href tag. It means it provides generally provides here. You must notice one thing here, it provides even hyperlink also. See, here it provides this hyperlink, if you click here, then it will turn to this Google page. Okay, now what if at all I didn't give any URL? Let me explain that case also. What will be happened in that type of case? Here I'm not mentioning anything, here I'm everything blank. Let me close my anchor tag. This A means it is an anchor tag. Generally, it is used for giving links. Let me see. What is this blank page, right? Here it is not redirecting to any web page, because here I'm not mentioning any URL. If at all, see, if you click here Google, then it will redirect. This is the difference between the mentioning URL and mentioning URL and mentioning not URL, like the link with the link address and without link address. This is an about this is all about the anchor tag. Okay, let me delete. Yeah. I'm so tired today. And there are some other tags also, that is a SRS tag and everything. I will explain it in tomorrow's class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Is everything is clear till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay then. Santoshi, ma'am.
Actually, ma'am, Santosh ma'am is not here because the battery is so she didn't.
Sir, if at all you want to say anything, then you can please.
No, ma'am, wind up the session.
Sir, is it okay for you taking double classes?
No, ma'am, okay. It's okay.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Okay, guys, you can leave now.
Bye, ma'am.
Yeah, okay, bye. Take care, guys.